10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
The opinions expressed on the following sponsored program are strictly those of the host, guests, and callers, and not necessarily those of this station, its staff, management, or sponsors.
Welcome to the Eat and Critique Show with host Steve-O and Renee. Get ready to hear which South Florida restaurants serve the best seafood, Italian, Mexican, steak, and sushi. Who offers the best service, best portions, and atmosphere? Share your dining experiences with Steve-O and Renee each week while they share their dining experiences with you. Steve-O has written for the food and restaurant sections of the Boca Raton newspaper, Boca Raton Life, and the Parklander magazines, and is no stranger to radio. He has written a cookbook for adults and children, too. Steve-O is a graduate of the prestigious Cooper Clinic for Nutrition and Fitness, and he graduated from the Florida Culinary Institute. Renee is the president of communications and marketing for one of the top marketing companies in Florida, MBAs Inc. Now, let's get ready to call and share your dining experiences. Now, here's Steve-O and Renee.
Good afternoon and welcome to the Eat and Critique Radio Show, where Renee and I are restaurant critics and we go out and try to find the good, the bad, and the ugly when it comes to fine dining.
We found some ugly, by the way.
Oh, we have. Listen, today we are live here at Cafe Martorano in Fort Lauderdale with owner Steve Martorano. The last time we interviewed Steve, we had over 20,000 views.
That's to see him, not us.
Who cares?
Who cares about us?
So, but before we get started, you hear this
voice
chatter in the background, this voice.
You hearing voices, Steve-O? You hearing
my
voices?
My beautiful, my best friend in the world, Renee.
What's happening, Steve-O? Oh.
This is amazing.
Oh, he's clapping for me. See, I got a friend on the other side. I got two Steves today.
Oh, that's right, you do. I am so excited to be at Cafe Martorano. This is like heaven. For me, because I know a lot more about him than he does about me, because I've seen all the things that he's been involved in, from Jimmy Kimmel to me to Martha Stewart, and I said, this man right here is not, and I got in trouble last time I called him a chef. This man, this American-Italian cook here, has the insight to come across to people, and not just about cooking. There's more to his life, which we're going to find out today, than just about cooking.
Well, it's his passion for food. Yeah, it's so his whole line. He has a whole line. Wine, sauces, yokas.
So this is what we developed. We developed the yokas cooking section. It's a monthly segment we're going to do on our show. And we're flattered to have Steve. Welcome, Steve.
It's a pleasure
to be
here.
Welcome to the show, Steve.
Hi, Princess. How you doing?
Good. Oh, Princess. I am a princess. I love it.
I know I'm always late. Like I told you before, I ripped my pants getting in the car. Well, I had to change my pants and get back here, so I apologize for being late. That's not my style.
Listen, let me tell you something. Me too. I said I ripped my pants too.
Yeah, but did you change them?
Of course
I
did.
See, that's
I got to stand up. Right. What do you want me to do? I can't sit it all
time. You got to tell everybody, if you would like to watch this, and this is the way to do it, you got to watch this because Steve's going to be cooking today. Go to our website, www.theeatandcritiqueshow.com. As soon as you go to our website, wow, there we are.
There we are.
Big screen.
Voila.
And that's the best way to keep up with us. So,
okay, can I also say today we're going to be giving away concert tickets during our Out and About show with Steve-O and Renee segment for such artists and acts as All for One. You've heard of them, All for One.
Yeah, yeah.
I love them. We're going to go see them next week for Valentine's Day. And they're going to be at Jazzy's Nightlife in Meisner Park, Sister Act, and my man, Michael Bolton. And he's going to be at the Kravitz Center. I'm going to go see him for like the 100th time.
He eats in my joint all the time.
Oh, we're going to go down all the...
Wait a second.
There.
He eats here?
He's been here about 5 times. Hard Rock. A million times.
Oh, my God. I have to come when he
told me.
Listen, I'm like stalking the man.
He takes pictures with he takes pictures with bags of Cafe Martorano, like food he's taking home. Yeah, it's great.
Okay, listen, if he comes here, you got to give me a buzz.
I promise.
Okay, give me a heads up.
Hey, you had someone special in last night. The Godfather.
Oh, Carlo Rizzi?
Yeah.
Gianni Russo is, you know, when The Godfather came out, he played Carlo, which was the son-in-law.
Right.
Of
the daughter's husband.
The daughter's husband. And, you know, he's a New York guy, street guy, and sharp guy. He's been in a lot of other movies. He's been in a couple of Steven Seagal movies. But anyway, he loves coming here. But I had him about a year ago. It was a Friday night. The place was packed. He said, "Stevie, give me the microphone." I said, "Oh, I said, wait a minute. What's this guy going to sing? I don't know if he can sing or not." I said, "Well, what are we going to do? Just give me the microphone and shut the music off." I shut the music off for 1 hour, 1 hour and 20 minutes. He talked about what it was like being on air. He told what it was like, how he got the part, and how it changed his life. And he took questions from the customers. I mean, stuff like that happens.
Only that's pretty cool. That's very cool.
All the time, yeah. So it was amazing.
I'm going to come here one night and do that. I'm going
to
take questions from the audience.
I grew up in the 70s, right? I grew up in the 70s and 80s. This guy is still pressed out. When I say pressed,
what does that mean?
Suit, tie, handkerchief, to the tee. That's whenever I see him.
To make
him.
You and I look bad, huh?
No, I'm telling you, he's like, remember back in the day when he used to go out to the nightclub?
Right.
He used to put that suit on because he always looks like you're right.
Like this, like the picture in the back of your book.
Just
listen,
like
I think I dated you in the
70s. Could have been.
I think I met you at Studio 54.
I was there.
Yeah, me too. We talked about that.
You had platforms on, did you?
Oh, I had orange ones. Cause.
No, the white white shoes.
And hot pants. I don't know if you remember hot pants.
I wore hot pants.
In the 70s. For guys, it was an in thing to hop pants. Oh, yeah.
No way.
Oh, yeah, wow. I did it all.
Wait a second, the men didn't wear hot pants.
Yes, they did. They were called hot pants in Philly.
But they weren't really short.
No, not like you got like these.
Okay, shorts. Not like the ladies wear.
No, but they were short. They called them hot pants.
Okay, because don't scare me.
Well, let's talk about one of the things that really turns me on about your life is your passion for food, life, for God.
Number one comes first.
Right.
Comes first. Always comes first. I mean, we talked about it before. I don't know. You want to
see,
back?
And we have about 100,000 more people today than we did.
God bless you. That's
yeah,
right,
6 months.
Well, it's a much bigger station now.
And you know, as it works, is you can't just sit around.
Sit around.
You got to always have the gloves on, right?
No, you sit
okay,
around.
Okay, there's no sitting around when you want to be successful.
You know, people say to me all the time, how's it feel to be successful? I said, I don't know. I still work. So, you know, people go, why don't you just relax, enjoy life?
There's no relaxing.
I'm not relaxed. That's just what I do. People that relax and sleep all day are people that are broke.
That's right.
So I'm not, I got to keep moving because there's always somebody, because there's a guy right now listening to you and your beautiful lady. They want your job.
Oh, absolutely.
They want what
you know
you're
what?
At.
They're not getting it.
You
work too hard.
Work harder for that.
That's right.
Well, I know there's so many people right now. This is what I'm going to love having on the show for. There's so many people right now who are down on their luck, and they think, hey, the world's coming to an end.
Right, with the economy the
but
way it is.
But you know what? Listen, you probably thought a few times the world was coming to an end, too. What am I going to do with my life?
It still happens. People don't realize it. I came from the streets of Philly, right? I started a business in a basement of my mother's basement, right? I put flyers. I used to pick flyers. I would go outside myself. I didn't have like a crew, no company. And I put flyers on people's windows or their cars. I put them in mailboxes. And I would go home and wait for the
knock
phone.
On the ring, right?
Yeah,
the
ring.
But you started out making sandwiches.
It was Italian hoagies and cheesesteaks, right? And you were talking about the book, but I was in the music business a little bit. I was a DJ in clubs. Music business was a club guy. Made $75 to $100 a night spinning music. But that's what my true love back in the day, which still is too, is music. But you had to do something else.
Right.
I had an opportunity to be involved in a lot of street things. And that street life, that's my goal is to get... That's why I created the Yo-Cuz brand. If you see the Yo-Cuz brand anywhere, know that if you was to purchase, buy something, wear a shirt, a hat, a piece of jewelry that has Yo-Cuz, proceeds go to help a child.
I know, which is really, really cool.
But because nobody gave me that opportunity. My My guy that I looked up to was the boss of Philadelphia. His name was Angelo Bruno. The guy that I looked up to was my uncle, who was part of that crew named Raymond Martorano. I wanted to be that. That's all I knew.
That's right.
Never went to school. Didn't think about school. All I wanted to do was earn, get on the street and earn. Before you know it, everybody's dying. Everybody's going to jail. I have a cousin. He's in prison for life for a marijuana charge. He's been in prison for 32 years.
Wow.
Nonviolent crime, 32 years, life without parole, and he took a plea. When you take a plea, you know what that means?
No.
I'm facing 100 years. If I get found guilty, give me the plea. Maybe I get 50 years. You took a plea.
Wow, that's crazy.
He took the plea. And he,
George.
Oh, he took it, and he got life without parole.
Wow.
So, you know, he's railroaded, so I'm trying to get him home. But back to what I was, what the old cuz brand and helping kids is, I know from the streets, it's a dead end. Streets don't love you. They don't care about you.
You got to fight to get out.
And your question to me was, do I care and worry about? Every day you have to fight. We live in a time that you have to go after what you want. Nobody's going to say, here it is, cuz, go do it. Here's $1 million. Don't
work
like that.
But Steve, that's always the case.
It's always been that way, correct? I mean, my grandparents, when they came here.
If you want to make something of yourself, you got to get up and do it yourself.
Right,
you can't depend on other people.
Right.
And by the way, did you see he's wearing your yoga hat?
Yeah, I see.
I tried to make him wear the pink one today, but he wouldn't wear that.
Let's talk about your locations. Okay. Fourth location. Let's talk about your three that are open now.
The one here in Fort Lauderdale, my baby, the one that I love, the one that like is my heart, where I sweated to get to where I'm at
today.
Where
you first started, the first restaurant.
Is 23 years old.
This start off 800 square feet? This is the one that...
800 square feet.
Wow.
One stove. Now it's 3,200 square feet. Took me 23 years to keep growing. It just didn't happen overnight. I opened my door. Listen, when I say open my door with $40, cuz, $40. I came to Florida with like $85,000. I had to put a deposit on a house. I had to buy this. There's no money left. One credit card, $40. It was me, a cook, and I said, if I don't make it, then I got to go to a credit card. And that's what I didn't want to do.
Right. So, but look at you now. It's incredible.
Yeah, but you know what people say, like, wow, your dream. What dream? You know what my dream was? Pay bills and put a roof over my kid's head. That was the dream. There was no vision of where I'm at now.
That's right.
That's what God had blessed me.
But isn't the dream, you know, still the same now? You just...
I didn't have... No.
God, just give me a roof over my head.
Yeah, because I didn't have a dream, but I have one now because there's a vision that I didn't have before. I didn't have a vision of helping. Just wanted to pay my bills. Now, again, God put in my life a situation, and I gave him my word. Never forget this. I said, if I become successful, let me still stay humble. If I become successful, I promise you that I will give back. If I stop, take it all away from me. You know, so...
No, but you have, because even the other day when we met, you said... You know that you're not a celebrity, and you are. I mean, you definitely
listen,
a celebrity.
Chris, thank you, and I get that.
And I'm not saying that to like suck up to you.
No,
because I don't suck up to anybody.
No.
I'm just saying that you really are. I mean, you're on a lot of shows. I mean, you are a celebrity chef. That's the way I see
that's
it.
That's how you see it,
yes,
right?
Yes, absolutely.
I see
you
it.
Agree with me, Steve-O?
Absolutely.
I just see it a little bit. Like, I want people to see me, and I want them to see that we give back. If that makes sense.
Yeah, because you're a real person.
That's,
like I said,
you know,
like,
even that don't sound, that sounds
no,
phony
I,
to me.
No,
saying sounds phony, like, because I'm saying it, we're talking about it. Like, I didn't really want to do this show. I didn't want to do it because you were saying to me, we want to talk about your brand, we want to talk about all the good things you did.
Right. You want to talk about me? We can talk about
you. Yeah, we can talk about you.
Talking about me?
But it doesn't sit in my soul, right? It's like, okay, like, do I really want to talk about all that? Like, let my actions speak for itself, and that's why my girls...
Okay, but listen, you can talk about our show now if you want.
Okay, sure,
next
sure.
Half hour, we can talk about
yes,
our show.
Okay.
Like, people are shutting off the radio, but you can talk about us.
No, but let's talk about your other locations, too.
Okay, which...
Let's start off at Hollywood.
Where I start,
okay.
Yes. Well, this was the first, and the second one was in Vegas. Was at the Rio. Okay, now we have been at the Rio 6 years. Rumors have been started from the moment, as we all know, that haters and people that don't want to see you get ahead, well, at least they want to see you get ahead and not get that far ahead.
Yeah,
you know,
we've come across a couple of those.
Every day,
25 times a day somebody says, oh, I heard you closed Vegas. No, I heard you closed Vegas. No.
I heard you going out of business.
How are you going, right? I'm there 6 years, and they just gave me another one. But after the Rio, the Hard Rock approached, and we opened up here at Hollywood, Florida. So that was the third. And now they just gave me a Paris location on the Strip.
Which is really cool.
Because we belong to be on the Strip. And we're right next to Gordon Ramsay Steakhouse. I didn't go to culinary school. I didn't go to business school. I just try to do what I think is right. And it's been working.
It has
so,
been.
You know, I'm here 23 years.
That's
a landmark.
That's an accomplishment. That really
just
is.
Just that alone.
Absolutely.
But the point being, anybody, like I tell people, you just said we live in a bad economy. I don't care what it is. If you got to make chocolates, you're making cakes, go knock on doors.
Listen,
try my cake, buy my cake, whatever you're going
to
do.
Survive.
Absolutely.
Well, I want to say one thing before we go any further. Is your mom, how's your mom doing? Lillian?
Oh, yeah, she has an issue, which we're going to take care of, but it looks everything's going to be fine. She's 84 years old. She tells me when I leave the house, what do you want to eat? What do I want to eat? Mom, go to a restaurant, Mom. What time are you coming home?
She's your mom, though. What do you expect? I do the same thing.
6 years old. What time I'm coming home? Yeah. Call me. Make sure you... That's what time
okay,
mothers
but that, and all Jewish moms.
Like,
okay,
yeah.
Jewish moms.
Yeah, all,
I'm a Jewish
moms,
mom.
All moms are like... Well,
Steve, you tweet a lot. I tweet a lot. It's part of the business.
I think I do a little bit
and
too much.
The other day I saw, I said, everybody please pray for my mom. So, uh-oh, something must be wrong. So, of course, I'm going to pray because of who I am.
Well, no, when you say who you are, I believe that
two or three
are gathered in the midst.
God's very important in my life. I've got a great relationship with him. And that was one of the things that really turned me on about your life. It's not just about the food.
I wanted to be a priest one time.
Get out of here, did you?
I wanted to be a priest.
Wow.
And I wanted to be a priest. That's what I thought about. And there was an old movie, which you probably never saw. It was called The Miracle of Marcellina. It's an old Italian movie.
No, I only saw the one on 34th Street.
It's about a little Italian kid in Italy that was raised by the monks. And it was sad because he would go up to this room and they would say to him, you're not allowed upstairs in that room. And the kid never knew why. You know, you tell somebody, no, they can't want to keep doing it. And he would go up there and he would have a conversation. Before you know it, he's having a conversation with Christ on the cross. And they found out that he was up there. And one time he had gotten really sick, and he went and he wanted to see his mother. And the next scene you see is a little boy. Christ is holding the little boy in his arms.
Wow.
No, we never saw that movie.
Well, by the way, we just noticed.
Now, listen, this my point being is that you need something to believe in.
Absolutely.
Mine's God. I know yours is too.
You ain't got that, cause you don't have nothing in this world. Nothing.
No. You know, we just noticed for the first time, there's a gentleman sitting
Wait a second. Back up. Wait a second.
There goes.
I'm sitting over there, and I have really bad eyesight. And I said, wait a second. Is that Steve Martorano up on the balcony?
I was laughing. Well, this scene is from New York City, which you should be.
Of course I know that. You can't tell I'm from New York, right?
I'm from Philly, so right. This was the first one I found that I loved. And we changed a couple other characters. Did you notice or you didn't notice?
Renee said, that's Steve. I said, no
that's
way.
He doesn't understand that I'm always right. He's got to learn that.
She might not always be right, but she's never wrong.
Exactly. But he has to tell me that I'm right, though.
Hey, we are going to go to our first break. We got to pay some bills. And when we come back, we're going to talk about some of the other celebrities who've come in here. Because let me tell you something.
Being a sports agent,
I was for 12 years. Oh, yeah. A lot of football players. Listen, if the athletes and the stars come to your restaurant, you're doing something well.
Wait a second. Michael Bolton eats here. I got to come back when Michael Bolton's here. What are you, crazy?
Okay, so we'll be back in just a minute. We're going to hear about some of the other celebrities that come to Cafe Monterano. We'll be right back. Hi, this is Steve O, co-host of the Eat and Critique Show. I want to talk to you about my favorite deli, 2J's, with 24 locations throughout South Florida, 11 of them right here in Broward and Palm Beach. Most of us have ordered out from 2J's at one time or another, from those morning business meetings to bar mitzvahs, or maybe you ordered one of their great holiday trays. What I love about 2J's is how consistently good they are and how my orders are always accurate and on time. Whatever occasion we are celebrating and I'm put in charge of the food, I know ordering from 2J's will always be a hit. From their cheese trays to their meat trays, 2J's never disappoints me are our company. You can always tell the difference between the 2J's trays and the other trays at parties, as 2J's trays are always the ones that are devoured. Finally, I can't forget about 2J's latkes, or their stuffed cabbage, or their matzo ball soup, which are just like my Nana used to make. Go to their website to find out the location nearest you at www.2js.com. That's T-O-O-J-A-Y-S. Tell them Steve O and Renee sent you from the Eat and Critique Show.
This is Les Gold of Hardcore Pawn, American Julian Loan, and I've got the two best people in South Florida, Steve O and Renee, my favorite people on the radio.
If you're listening to our show right now, you could watch us right now on the EdenCritiqueShow.com website, and that's done by the amazing technology of amp2.tv.
I got to bring up an address. This is going to blow your mind.
Oh, go for it.
767 South 6th.
That's my grandmother's. That's where
Mary.
Yeah, she did your homework.
I think he's stalking you.
But yes, that's South Philly, because that's
she's taught you how to cook.
She taught everybody how to cook. You know what I'm saying? That she was always in the kitchen, always with a spoon, always with a cast iron frying pan.
That's what Italian grandmas do. Yes.
Okay. In my book, my first book is called Yoko's My Life, My Food, My Way. Okay. My grandfather used to go mushroom hunting. You know, he used to go hunting for mushrooms. So we would go to Kennett Square and we would hunt mushrooms. But there are some poisonous...
I was going to say, are those edible?
There are some poisonous mushrooms. My grandmother used to cook them, make him eat it first. Because if anything happened, he would go before the kids.
So she actually was trying to kill him.
I'm just saying. True story. She used to say, just call him the gink, gink. You taste it first, and she'd wait. All right, he's all right. We can eat it.
That's funny. Right, oh, listen, I'm going to go mushroom hunting tonight.
You know, I'm going to say something. Bro,
you can try some mushrooms.
If I hurt your feelings at all, I just, sometimes, you know, I just, you pray about something and this is what I want you to do. I have this feeling that your dad and your grandmother are looking down going, we're so proud of our son and our grandson.
Thank you, cousin.
Is that okay to say?
You know, like someone asked me who you wish you can cook for. My grandmother and my father, because they never had an opportunity to see that, you know.
Listen, can I say something? I can relate to that, because we started the show a year ago, but my mother passed away. My mother, my best friend, passed away a few years ago. So I know she's watching, because I talk to her before every show.
You should.
And I know she's watching.
Yeah, you should.
So
let's talk about some of the celebrities that come in here.
Who do you want to talk about?
God, I'm a sports fan, so New England Patriots come in here.
When this place,
Rangers.
When this... Wow, you really do your homework.
But listen, I'm an Islander fan.
Are you really?
Yeah. I used to have season tickets to the Islanders.
My first celebrity was Dan Marino, okay? When this place was 800 square feet, and he came in with his wife, and they're sitting and they're eating. At the time, I had a small speaker, house kind of speaker, and I was playing the Tramps and Harold Melvin and the Blue Notes.
Love them.
All the old school music. Really low, not loud like we do today. She comes over to me, Mrs. Marino. She says, excuse me, I'm Mrs. Marino. Nice to meet you. Can I have a tape? Tape now, not CD, tape. I said...
My 8-track.
I said, I don't have it. This is all my music that I keep. I'm doing it myself. So they were like the first ones. Her and Dan, they love the music. And that's with them saying what they said to me is when I said, maybe a lot of other people would like that Philly sound. So that's what we did. My second person was Tony Bennett.
And wow, that's big.
But do you want to hear a true story? That's got nothing to do with Tony. So let's get it clear.
Okay.
Tony.
Because I love Tony.
I'm in the gym. I'm working out. I'm open a couple months, right? I'm struggling. Phone rings. It's one of my workers. He goes, guess who's in town? Tony Bennett. Guess what? They want to come and eat. Oh, God.
You're probably dying, right? You're like, oh, my God.
Run. I got a Tony Bennett. I don't have Sinatra, so I don't have Demore, so I got...
That's the next best thing.
Right, I take him. But there's an issue. What's the issue? They want a discount. What do you mean?
They want a discount?
They want to know how much off on the food. I said, hold up, guys. I said, I'm on the phone. Listen to me. I just started. How many tickets can he give us for free? You know what I'm saying? He goes, nobody's going to give us no tickets. I told him, we can't do it. I hung up the phone.
Wow.
So he calls back. The kid who works for me, they call back. They want to know if you can give him a break on the liquor. There's a guy up the street. We'll give him a break on the...
You guys are kidding me.
Are you kidding me? Tony Bennett? How much money does it? I'm not thinking right. It's not Tony Bennett. He put somebody in charge. He might have said, here's $1,000. Go find a joint. The guy might have said, go get, if he gets something for $500, right. He could put $500 in his pocket. I get the deal. So I said, I hung up the phone, no. But anyway, they called back and they said, yeah, they would do it. So he came in, he sat down. He doesn't eat meat. He has shkodol and beans without the meat. That was my second, but I went.
So how many years ago was that? That was a long time ago,
when
right?
I first opened my doors, 23 years ago.
That was like 23 years ago,
you know?
Wow.
We had Peyton Manning, we had Archie Manning.
Does anybody ever
father.
Do that to you still?
What's that? No.
Ask you for a deal?
No. Yeah.
Except me, I'm Jewish. I'll sometimes I need a deal, you know?
Only deal we get you get a check.
That's yeah.
But like I said, Peyton Manning, Archie Manning, Joe Montana, Tom Brady. Every time the Patriots play, we cook for them every year.
How about what's that tall guy's name that happened to play for the Heat?
That's the when Shaq. That's my guy. That's my man. That's,
did he kind of give you something special?
What do you mean the tall
special?
Guy? What are you talking about?
It's a true story. He came in, he sat down, he ate, and it was time for dessert. So we put a tray of cakes and cookies, and I don't want this. What do you mean? I want fettuccine Alfredo. After he had dinner.
He wants the good food.
He wanted something else better.
He's a big dude.
He's a big kid, and we took a liking to one another. So when they won the championship, he got me a championship ring with my name on it from the Miami Heat. And
he gave it to you?
He gave it to me, yeah.
I need some good friends like that.
Even I did Ludacris's birthday party. He was 30 years old, and he had like 600 people at the party, and we cooked for them. And he had 40 rings for 40 special friends, and he gave me one of them too. Which
that's very cool. And,
you know, these are just relationships, or just treating people right. We don't go over the top with them because of who they are. You know what I'm saying?
This
we
is just, what happens when you give.
Oh yeah.
See how right, it comes give back.
Because different I believe. We turned Madonna down. We did. We turned Madonna down. She. We had Steven Tyler. Steven Tyler was having dinner. And a limousine pulled up, a driver came in, so I have a couple people out here with Madonna. She wants to come have dinner. We had like a 2.5 hour wait. I had Steven Tyler with 25 bodyguards around. The place is like going crazy. I said, I can't help you. I got regular people at that bar spending their money. It ain't right for me just to bring Madonna in. Because
you're not going to throw everybody out for hot. That's not right.
Right.
Of course not.
Are you booked for Valentine's Day?
Booked out.
Okay,
listen,
there goes Valentine's Day.
Okay, no, because I was going to say, this venue in Fort Lauderdale, which give your address here, by the way.
It's 3343 East Oakland Park Boulevard.
Okay, and your phone number.
We don't answer the phone. If you want to make a reservation, you go to Open Table.
Oh, okay.
And then you go to my website, cafemartorano.com.
It's time for you guys to start cooking.
Are you bossing me around now?
No,
I wouldn't go there if I were you.
Time. It's cooking time.
Okay, I'm going in the kitchen with Steve Martorano.
We're
going
to go to break, and I'm telling you something. Go to www.theeatandcritiqueshow. You've got to watch this. This man has a way of coming across and teaching how to cook like no one I've ever seen. Ladies,
he's gonna
you
show
wanna,
me.
You
wait a
watch
second.
This.
He's going to show me how to cook. Because I need some lessons, baby. I
not
need
really.
Some lessons.
You're
yeah,
a phenomenal cook.
Okay.
Wow.
See,
phenomenal.
That's love, that's
it's not love. He's just sucking up. Listen, he's going in for surgery tomorrow.
Yeah,
so
tomorrow I go in for a full hip replacement.
Get out of here.
Tomorrow morning, yeah. Had to
you're
do the show.
Prayers, you're in my prayers tonight. Yeah, you're be
right,
fine.
So he's got to suck up to me big time now because he can't move.
You're going to need her for a while.
That's right.
Hey, I've got everybody at Calvary Chapel Church in Fort Lauderdale praying for me.
That's great.
Doesn't get any better than that. Hey, we will be right back, and we're going to just, this is going to be fun.
Hi, this is Steve-O from the Eat and Critique Show. Both Renee and I are seeing our listening and viewing audience grow every week. Our audience is 45-plus with expendable income who dine out 3 to 5 times a week. Go to our website at the Eat and Critique Show and see all the Broward and Palm Beach County restaurants who are involved with our show. Restaurants such as Tasso's Greek Taverna, Cafe Martorano, Coco's Asian Bistro, The Meatball Room, 2J's, Jazz's Nightlife, Seminole Hard Rock, Piccolo, Restaurante, Maggiano's Italian Restaurant, and Cafe Blue, plus many others. Come join us and market your restaurant on the hottest weekend radio show, targeting people who eat out 3 to 5 times a week. Our show is simulcast every week, so your chef can show off their dishes and plating. Come join us on our show and talk about your happy hour, your entrees, your new menu, your brunch, or any other specials you might be having. Call us now to invite Renee and myself to dine at your restaurant, and then come on our show. We can create a great dining promotion to drive drive traffic to your restaurant. Call us at 954-336-3767 or just go to our website, www.theeatandcritiqueshow.com.
This is Renee from the South Florida Eat and Critique Radio Show. We want to welcome a new friend to our show, AMP2.TV, the first and only internet television network that's truly plugged in. When Steve-O and I went searching for an internet production company, we discovered AMP2.TV, a full-service production company who now handles all our streaming videos. They offer web page development, and they use the latest platforms to help make your business selling points more powerful. They can do remotes, live streaming, as well as tape productions. Let AMP2.TV handle any of your television production needs. They have all sorts of creative TV production packages to choose from. See why AMP2.TV works with Comcast, Bravo, The O, and Fox 29. To see owner Freddie Santori's work, go to our website at www.steveoandreneeshow.com. Scroll down on the left side bottom of our homepage where you will find AMP2.TV's great work they did for us. To contact them, go to www.amp2.tv.
I swear.
Hi, we're All For One.
And we'll be playing at Jazz's Nightlife on February 13th and 14th, and we hope to see you there.
Like the shadow that's by you.
New York,
it's
Cafe Martorano.
Martorano. So say it. How do you pronounce
Martorano.
It?
Martorano.
Martorano. Okay. Awesome. So what are we going to be cooking today? Because you're going to be showing me how to cook, and I need lessons.
We got two things. We're going to make homemade mozzarella.
Mozzarella.
Okay. We're going to make a spaghetti or a fettuccine marinara. Which tomato basil, real simple. I'm going to show you how quick and easy it is. You can do it at home.
Simple.
That's the idea, but...
I know.
Now, you want to get your hands dirty with me at all?
I'm going to get my hands dirty.
So you tell me what you want to do first.
You want to do the pasta first? Let's do the sauce first.
Macaroni.
We're making macaroni.
Okay. Right. So I thought it was like macaroni and cheese.
When you make macaroni and cheese.
No, we never call it. My mother would say, go to the store and go get a box of macaroni. She would never say, go get a box of pasta.
My mother did, but I'm Jewish. She said, go get me a box of pasta.
Did she really?
Okay. Only if we're making macaroni and cheese, she'd say, get me some macaroni.
So if she was making regular tomato sauce, what would she say?
Get me some.
That's amazing. All right. What we need is some boiling water, right?
Okay.
You got to salt the water. Okay, just grab a little pinch of salt.
All right, so I'm salted.
Give me a
salt. Okay, perfect. There we go.
You're gonna do one more.
Okay. More. All right. Look at this.
I'm cooking with Steve Martorano, Steve-O.
You see me over here?
You want to flavor the water now.
I'm not Steve Martorano. I get that. I just had my nails done, by the way.
You know what fettuccine is?
No, what is fettuccine?
Lini, always L-I-N-I, lini means thinner. So you got spaghetti, fettuccine, cappellini. If you ever go to a restaurant and they got cappellini on the menu with tomato sauce, cappellini is for soup. This is what you use if you want a thin macaroni. Fettuccine means thin.
Not angel hair pasta. That's really thin.
It's for soup.
That's too thin. I don't like that.
Well, this is fettuccine.
Because I like my pasta a little chewy.
Okay. It's always got to be that way. Always. I want you to feel that.
Okay, I'm feeling
it. I want you to feel how thin it is. I want you to grab this like this. I want you to throw it in.
I'm grabbing the pasta.
Throw it in the water.
You know what I end up doing?
No, don't do that.
I'm not going to break it. But I'm saying when I cook in the house, I break the spaghetti.
For soup. How do you twirl it?
You see with a fork. I'm going to twirl it. Listen, I'm a Jew girl over here.
Steve, I got a teacher.
I'm a Jewish girl over here from New York. I break the pasta.
Mother cook, right? The Jewish ladies.
My mother was
always,
a really good
cook. Right? All right, so we got a hot pan.
Okay, so what are we putting in there?
Extra virgin olive oil.
Which I love. Okay.
Which is the best. Yeah. God damn it. Just keep them squeezing. I'm going to count to 10. Come on. 1, 2, 3, 4, 8, 9, 10.
Okay.
That's Italian. That's how we do it.
All right, cool.
I want you to get yourself
two. Getting hot back here.
I want to get you two clothes of garlic. Get two clothes of garlic.
Look, I'm actually cooking. I can't believe it. Okay.
Put your two clothes down. I'm going to do one, you're going to do one. I'm going to punch it.
I like the way you do it much better.
Push it down. Don't be afraid.
I'm not going to get cut.
You got it.
I think I just got cut.
You're good. No, you're good.
Okay.
Put your garlic in here.
I think I see some blood stains.
You're fine. Put the garlic in here.
Okay.
Now, the key to this whole dish, it takes 5 minutes. You want to get a nice color on the garlic.
Yes.
You don't need color on the garlic. What color is that? Like a brown?
It's almost brown.
I'm going to take some. Italian tomatoes.
Okay.
Which are San Manzano tomatoes.
Which are the best.
The best in the world.
Wow.
When I tell you, right now,
unbelievable.
5 minutes, you're done.
Okay.
I want to take a little bit of salt.
Right.
I'm going to take a little bit of black pepper.
See, for those of you that have just listened to us on the radio, you need to go to the website at the Critique Show so you can see Steve Martorano.
Martorano.
Cooking in the kitchen.
Fork.
Because you don't want to miss this.
A fork. All you want to do is smash these.
Brush out the tomatoes a little bit.
You already put salt and pepper.
Right.
I'm going to get myself a little bit of Vazenagol.
Vazenagol.
Which is basil.
Yes.
Which is basil.
Right? I know.
A little bit of
I'm
basil.
Up on that.
Now, what you do is this. You sit and you wait. Because that takes 3 minutes.
You got to cook
that,
into it,
yes,
right.
But the key to this has to be done before the macaroni.
Right.
The macaroni can't wait for the sauce. The sauce can wait for it.
Because it sticks together.
Sticks together and then it keeps cooking. So then
I know.
Mushy.
You know what I do?
No, I'm saying.
I've been in the sink and I dump cold water.
No, what's wrong?
I'm telling you, this is why I need lessons from you, okay? What do I know?
Do you use a strainer?
I'm not a chef.
Do you use a strainer?
I use a strainer. Am I not supposed to?
No, you want to take it.
You want to drain it with my hands?
No, you want to take it right out of here.
Yeah.
Into here.
How do you do that without the water?
Listen,
when I said I need lessons from you, I'm not joking.
Yeah. See this macaroni water?
Yeah.
Has so much flavor. Starch. So when you're cooking your marinara sauce, put a little bit of the water.
See, this is tricks of the trade over here. Very cool.
Let's just say you made a lot of it and it was drying out.
Right.
Keep adding the macaroni water. You understand?
Yes.
All flavor.
I love it. Yep, I do understand that. Okay, so while
That sauce is done. I'm just waiting for the macaroni.
Perfect.
Yeah.
So why don't we do the fresh mozzarella?
Okay.
Do you like the way I said that?
Say it again?
Mozzarella.
What did they say? Mozzarella, passadana. You gotta use mozzarella.
Okay, mozzarella.
Let's clean ourselves up a little bit.
Okay.
Then as soon as
I'm
that
getting
with
this nice stand here.
Curd. Comes from milk.
Yes.
And you put an enzyme called rennet and it separates.
I know, this is what happens when I leave the milk in the refrigerator for too long.
No.
That's what it looks like.
No. Listen, well, when it separates, you're going to have curd and whey. Like the
right.
song, curd and whey. This is what you got. This is the curd. The whey, you make ricotta.
Ah.
So you're making it from the milk. You can make two different things.
Okay,
great.
Very cool.
You got this. Let's get a little bit of... I want you to take 2 teaspoons of salt, put it in here.
Okay, so this is a teaspoon. So I got 2 of those. Okay.
Yeah, I am.
Okay.
Watch. 2.
Okay.
One.
I like a lot of salt.
Well, some people can't have salt, so you can make this.
I know, but I told them I like the salt, but I don't.
But you don't. But you don't.
Yeah, I don't. You know, because otherwise it doesn't have the same taste.
This is hot water at 180 degrees.
Okay, I'm stepping away from it.
Yeah, you're not going to get burned. You're not. Okay. I promise you're not going to get burned.
Okay. I trust you.
I should have got you a pair of gloves.
Why? Because he has to stick my hands in this?
You don't have to. You can watch me.
I'm
going to
watch you.
But once it gets...
My nails will melt.
No, but once it gets a little cooler, I'm going to show you.
Now I'm really excited. I can do it. You can mix it for me, Steve.
No. Look at me. That's it? You're going to make mozzarella. I mean, this is it. Salt, hot water. That's it. You want to melt it. So get your spoon.
Okay. And then you just mix it around. So
just make sure it starts to melt.
Perfect.
It. You want to get all these things to come together as one.
How come mine's not mixing up?
Yeah, it will.
Okay.
Feel the water. Does that feel too hot for you?
I'm not sticking my hands in 180 degree water.
No. Seriously, I wouldn't burn. Is that too hot for you?
No, actually it's not that hot. I'm surprised. Okay,
now watch what I'm doing. I'm bringing it towards myself.
Okay.
Bringing it towards. Keep doing it.
Okay.
Come to you. Like that. Come to you.
All right. So it's actually going to like form into...
Okay. Yeah, like a ball.
Yeah, exactly. Okay.
I'll pick yours up. I'll pick yours up.
I have to tell you, I do cook at home.
Yeah, but
I'm trying to make matzo ball soup.
I love mussels.
I make the best chicken soup ever. I'm going to make it for Passover. No, it's not hot at all.
You know, I want you to watch. You know, okay. Relax, we're not making our beats. We're not making beats.
I'm making
watch,
a baseball.
I want you to stretch a little bit.
Okay.
Just a little bit. Put it back in
it's
water.
It's almost like dough.
Yes, put it back in the water.
Okay.
The idea is, do you feel the lumps? Still feel a couple lumps?
Not really. It's not that bad.
Yeah, but you want them to go away. They have to leave. They got to get nice and smooth. They got to go bye-bye.
Okay.
You know what I mean?
That's why yours is going to taste much better than mine.
Yeah, but because I didn't, first time I did it, I didn't know what I was doing. I had to keep doing it and doing it and doing it. That's how you learn. Stretch it out.
Okay.
So yeah, you stretch it. You got it, right?
Yep.
Yours don't look as pretty as mine, but.
Of course
but
not.
Your
I'm
first
not a
time. Yeah, but it's your first time. You got it? No,
I got it. And put it back in the water again?
Put it back in the water. You want to keep melting it.
Okay.
And now look.
Mine's getting a little harder.
That's
now.
Okay. Let me feel.
Right?
Oh, yours
getting like rubber.
Box. Well, look how smooth mine is looking.
Yeah.
Where's that camera? Anybody got a camera? Cuz, get a camera. Look over here.
Don't aim it on mine. Mine's not that smooth.
Look, do you see how, look how simple. Cuz, you're done. This mozzarella is done.
I know, but mine doesn't look like yours.
You want to know why?
Why?
Because you're not.
Because I'm not you?
You got to treat it like a woman. You got to treat it with a
okay,
lot of care.
Okay, but you're a man. So
but you know how a woman needs to be treated, right? So the same way, you take your time.
Oh, you see that?
You
look at that.
You take your time. You take your time.
Okay.
You just made mozzarella.
Hey, Steve-O, I just made mozzarella.
Just made, that's it, you're done.
I'm going to bring it over to the table so you can try it.
Now look.
Okay, so where's our pasta and sauce?
It's coming. I want you to put this on the plate.
Mine doesn't look that bad, huh?
It looks good.
Okay.
Here's mine.
Do we have paper towels? I'll use this under the knife.
Now you're learning. Get a little bit of olive oil.
And pour it over?
Pour it all over.
This actually looks like liquor, doesn't this? This bottle of
butter.
Yeah. I was almost going to take a swig.
No, put a little bit on. Put a little bit on.
On top? Okay, so I'm going to put it on.
The whole thing. Don't be afraid. Shake it up.
Okay, I'm putting this all over the olive oil, all over the mozzarella.
You're done, cuz.
Okay, that looks great. Yours looks much better than mine, though.
But I bet you after the second time and the third time you got it.
Okay.
Are you ready?
I'm ready for the pasta.
Here
bring it on.
Remember, I told you, look, put your pan on.
Oh, that sauce looks amazing.
Take your macaroni out.
Yep.
You want some of that water.
Oh, you put it into the sauce.
Yes, yes.
Oh, no. See, you know what I do?
What?
I put it into a bowl.
Oh, you can do that too, because this is, well, you want to coat that.
Okay, man. Perfect. All right, so let's put that on the plate, and we're going to bring it over to Steve-O, because we're going to go do a break.
Do a break,
and when we come back, you're going to get to see what we just created in the kitchen. We'll be right back.
You did good, kid.
Hi, this is Steve-O from the Eat and Critique Show. Both Renee and I are seeing our listening and viewing audience grow every week. Our audience is 45 plus with expendable income who dine out 3 to 5 times a week. Go to our website at The Eat and Critique Show and see all the Broward and Palm Beach County restaurants who are involved with our show. Restaurants such as Tasso's Greek Taverna, Cafe Martorano, Coco's Asian Bistro, The Meatball Room, 2J's, Jazz's Nightlife, Seminole Hard Rock, Piccolo, Restaurante, Maggiano's Italian Restaurant, and Cafe Blue, plus many others. Come join us and market your restaurant on the hottest weekend radio show targeting people who eat out 3 to 5 times a week. Our show is simulcast every week so your chef can show off their dishes and plating. Come join us on our show and talk about your happy hour, your entrees, your new menu, your brunch, or any other specials you might be having. Call us now to invite Renee and myself to dine at your restaurant and then come on our show. We can create a great dining promotion to drive traffic to your restaurant. Call us at 954-336-3767 or just go to our website www.theeatandcritiqueshow.com.
Yo, cuz, how you doing? This is Steve Martorano of Cafe Martorano in Fort Lauderdale and at the Hard Rock Seminole Hotel and Casino and at the Rio in Las Vegas. And I love turning into my friends Steve-O and Renee, Eat and Critique Radio Show.
Was that fun?
That was a lot of fun. Did you see the mozzarella we made?
Oh, I know. Listen, I can
and
smell.
Macaroni.
Can you tell who made what? You can't tell. That's how good she did.
See how good I am?
Yeah. So and you'll
give
be
me
able
credit
to make
for
it at night now.
No, come to see. You're gonna have to come here to eat it.
Wow.
I will never make that again unless I'm in the kitchen with my water. Don't push your luck over there, buddy.
This is like deja vu because I've seen so many of your videos, talk shows you've done,
yes.
And this is one of my favorite dishes that you make.
Thank you.
Do you want to taste it?
Oh, I can't wait.
Okay.
And guess who else we've got now here with us?
We have
can we call her your better half?
Well, I'm your better half,
your equal
so.
Half.
Yeah, no, she's my world.
Hi.
Hi. Marcia Daly.
Marcia Daly is in the house with us.
Best makeup artist in the world.
Well, we're going to talk about that. And
yes.
Listen,
If and I need been some tips. I have to tell you, I need some tips, but we'll talk later.
Okay.
If it hadn't been for Marsha, this would have never been put together.
She put everything
together.
We've
been working on this for such a long time.
You guys are awesome.
And we just hope that it just grows. But
okay, can I just ask her one question? I was sitting in the sun yesterday. I know nobody cares about this, but all of a sudden, I woke up this morning and I had swollen eyes. And I used tea bags. See, I made Steve-O tea, so I used...
Let me tell her. I'll tell her.
Okay, wait a second. Wait a second. Let me just tell you. So this morning I made some tea. Steve-O wanted some tea. Uh-huh. And I used some of it on my eyes, and I still gave him the tea, though. I hope you don't mind. You didn't know the difference, right?
That was the same tea?
If it had a funny taste, I need
you
some tea bags for my eyes.
You
what's the trick?
Works? So yeah, mommy, tell her.
Preparation H.
Preparation H?
For preparation H.
The hemorrhoids?
Yeah. Well, what happens? Your hemorrhoids swell. And what do you do? You put that on there and it takes the swelling down.
I need some of that. I'm stopping.
I'm just I'm saying.
Yes.
Wow.
I should have called you first.
Get the cream. Yes. Yeah. Preparation
Welcome
cream.
To Dr. Oz, the Eat and Critique
See that?
Show.
No, because she's a cosmetologist, so she knows.
Preparation H.
No, I appreciate that. I'm good. I'm definitely going to use that. So if I smell like hemorrhoids.
I got this real. I went because I can't. I got to dig in. How long ago did you all meet?
9 years ago.
Nine years.
How'd you guys meet?
He fed me.
Oh,
he
my
fed
God.
You?
See? You could have met me sooner if you fed me.
It was a two and a half hour wait. She was standing by the wall. I walked over. I said,
here.
Yeah, I said, can I help you? She says, not really. I'm getting food to go. I said, well, okay, why don't you wait at the bar? There's no stool. So I got two guys to get up. She said,
did you throw him off the chair?
Did you know who Steve was?
No.
I thought he was a DJ.
Oh. Well, he is kind of.
So she sat down, and I just kept sending her food. So what would takeout wind up being 5 hours of eating? And then I made her a CD, like a love CD, because I'm a little romantic, you know?
So you need to take
lessons.
Listen to
that.
Write everything. What's your
when
pet?
She left, you know, she left. She went in her car. I know what she did. She probably couldn't wait to put that CD in, you know what I mean? Because she couldn't blame her. She was in love for the time she met
fell in love
me,
with him?
You know?
Love at first sight?
Yeah, 2 weeks later, I was getting a tattoo on my ankle.
Okay, I'm not getting any tattoos. Don't get crazy over there.
2 days.
2 days.
2 days.
Wow.
Okay, so you had all this food. What is your favorite dish here?
Everything.
Ooh, you got
it's
a train.
Very hard.
Really?
It's very hard.
Let me listen.
It's
she's
very hard. I never liked
she's
Italian
Jamaican,
food before.
Okay. She didn't eat meat for how long, Mom?
Till I was 17.
17
oh, wow.
years old. She never liked food. She would eat French fries and spaghetti with ketchup. I mean, not for nothing. She's Jamaican.
With ketchup.
Yeah, I mean, that's what she liked.
I didn't know any. Yeah.
She didn't know no better. Now I'll put her against Mario Batali on quality and how things are supposed to be cooked.
She knows. Right.
She knows it all
being
now.
With you.
Yeah.
Do you cook for her at home?
No, she does. She cooks for me. She
I
does. She makes
home.
Me. She'll make me.
From his recipes or your own?
My own.
Well, the first time, because you won't get mad. What if I tell
her? Yeah, don't do that.
I wanted a steak.
Don't
okay?
do that.
So I come. I wanted a steak.
Anyway.
She made the steak, and I said, you're going to put the steak on? On. It's been on. What do you mean? It's been on for about an hour and a half.
That's not true.
The steak's on for
an hour and a half.
That's not what happened.
I said,
that is not what happened.
Go ahead.
You said to make a steak. And I said, I don't really make steaks like this. It's not on the grill. Like, I don't know how to make it.
Right.
And Steve said, well, put it in the oven 45 minutes on each side. So,
I didn't say 45
yes,
minutes.
Did. 45
I
minutes
did
I think
side.
You might meant to say
like
45
Thank
minutes.
You. Thank you.
But
Thank
I
you.
Said I heard 45 minutes. Right. So it was a hockey puck when it came
no
out.
No jerk chicken or anything like that?
I make jerk chicken for him and curry chicken.
Yeah, she does.
Whoa. We got to dig in.
Okay, taste the food because we have 4 more minutes left. We're getting our cue here. And let me tell you something. Listen, I made all this. Okay, I'm just going to let you know.
Taste the macaroni.
Taste the macaroni. I'm going to say macaroni for now on. Okay? Because I'm going to be... Listen, I said before, this is my...
And you
mother
and
from
you,
another mother over there.
And so you say sauce, I say gravy.
Gravy,
okay.
Oh, that's the title of my new book.
Good, right?
It ain't sauce, it's gravy.
Gravy.
We
got to
get a lot of
that. Yeah, you say sauce.
Your family's here, or they're back in Jamaica?
I have half and half. My parents are here, my sister's here.
And you're a cosmetologist.
I'm a makeup artist.
I know, she's just getting tips my eyes, preparation.
She does Brandy, Monica, she does them all.
Yeah, I do a lot of celebrities.
Real fast also, because we have like a few minutes.
Yeah, we got a lot going on.
Okay, so he's got a book.
You have a new book coming out.
Yeah, this
right?
is called. This is my first self-published book.
I got to do one more.
That's out now. You can only get it at the restaurant or online at www.cafemartorano.com.
Right.
But Random House, Knopf, which is part of Random House, bought my book. It'll be out in September. It's going to be called It Ain't Sauce, It's Gravy.
That's what it's going to be called.
Okay.
And we have our own line of sauces because you can get this at Publix.
Steve, I got to tell you something. Yeah. Last week I made some macaroni at home, and I used the gravy.
Why?
It was phenomenal. See, I have to say, I loved it.
It's so simple that you get in Publix, you got to go to Publix, and if they don't have it, you tell the manager you want Cafe Martorano sauce. You know what she did?
What?
She went there, she loaded up her whole, she was shopping, food shopping, she bought everything. She happened to have a Willy, which means a taste for my sauce, Marcia, so she looked for it, it wasn't in there. She said to the manager, where's the Martorano sauce? Well, we don't carry it. She left the whole thing and she walked out.
Wow.
That's royalty.
Go ahead.
Next week on our show, Ann Burrell.
Oh, that's right.
Is going to be on our show.
Which
also, from Mob Wives. Renee
Graziano.
Those ladies, I said hello. They both know us.
I know.
Yeah, Renee just wrote a cookbook. That's so much fun.
So much fun.
And we have Todd English coming on this month. So we've got some really neat people. But
this
has been amazing. Now, we're going to be doing this once a month.
It's going to be our Yo Cuz Cooking Corner.
You've got to come on at the beginning, though.
I will.
Yes,
okay?
I will.
I have a ton of questions for you.
And I'm going to test out that preparation.
You got to do it. Do it tonight when you get high.
She keeps me focused. I was on my way down. She lifted me up.
You weren't seeing anybody at the time.
No, just my life was messed up.
We got to listen before we leave. The mozzarella is
delicious. Eat the macaroni.
Eat the macaroni. I slaved over a hot stove. Did you see me with the apron, by the way?
I saw you sweating.
Okay, you saw me. My hair got all like tumbled. Okay, is that delicious? Unbelievable. You love it.
You get that in a jar.
Wow.
Okay, I have it in a jar. I have it in the
so
house.
Good.
I used it.
Right.
Okay, we got 1 minute left. So
there's a reason why Cafe Martorano, you probably don't even know this. You're on our top 16 on our website,
awesome.
Which is very special. Gets about 30,000 hits a month.
Wow.
You are our top 16 restaurant.
Thanks, everybody.
Well deserved, really. Absolutely.
Now you can see why we want to have them on each month. This is, you got to come over here and eat. Let me tell you something. I don't care. We tell people, before you die, you got to come here to eat. And when it comes to the menu, close your eyes, point. That's all you got to do.
That's right.
Yeah. And we don't, we have a visual menu.
I know. They have the iPad.
Right.
Okay. We have the iPad. Okay, so we...
Thank you, guys.
Thank you so much for listening to us here today.
And peace and love.
We're out.
Bye.
They say we're young and we don't know. We won't find out until we grow. Well, I don't know while that's true, 'cause you got me, baby.